Hi there, Sandra here, and welcome to a new video. Guys, you have no idea how excited I am to share this video with you, where for the first time on my channel, I'm going to paint my first paint by number painting. The kit I have here was kindly sent me by Craft Ease, which they recently reached out to me and asked me if I was interested to receive one of their paint by number kit and make a video about it to share it with you. And yeah, I was so excited about it. It's an amazing coincidence that just few days before Craft Ease reached out to me, I was watching paint by number videos on YouTube that were randomly recommended to me, and I thought to myself that it would have been so cool to make a video about paint by numbers paintings. Because when I was in elementary school through middle school, I enjoyed painting them so much, and I still kept most of the ones I made, and they were my first proper introduction to painting. I always loved painting more than anything else, so paint by numbers is close to my heart and it's part of my artistic journey. So I'm excited to share with you today my experience, some tips and painting techniques for completing a paint by number project. But first of all, let's unbox the kit I received and show you everything that comes with the box. From Craft Ease, I received the full kit plus frame pro version. They have three types of kit you can choose from, but the pro version includes everything. So this kit contain, of course, the painting printed on high grade linen fabric canvas that is already framed on a wood frame. While I was painting, I found the linen canvas to be sturdy and good quality and easy to paint on. From Craft Ease, you can choose the kit with the painting pre-framed or unframed. I personally recommend the pre-framed because it makes the painting process a lot easier, but if you get the loose canvas, generally speaking, so not necessarily just from Craft Ease, I personally would recommend to pre-stretch your canvas before painting. And I like that the areas on the canvas are pre-colored with the according color, so it's not just printed on a white canvas, because this gives a subtle but general vision how to color it, and this would give a more opaque coverage as well. It's a small detail, but it's nice that there is. Then a thank you card and a picture of the finished painting with the swatches of all colors and the guideline stickers to label the colors with the numbers and the artist name, the original creator of this painting that I chose, who is Marla Jill. But I will tell you more about this later in the video. The guide to label the colors is very easy to understand. I remember with some paint by number kits I had when I was a kid, the labeling was sometimes confusing, but this was easy to understand. And having a printed image of the finished painting definitely came in handy, and it was nice to have it alongside while I was painting to double check that I labeled the colors correctly and I was doing everything right. Then there is a printed copy of the canvas with the numbers on it, which comes in handy when you have already covered an area with paint and you forget what number it was if you want to make any sort of adjustments. Then I received several brushes. The pro version comes with 10 professional paint brushes, which I believe is this set with the blue handle, but I got a few extra brushes, which is always nice to have. Regarding their quality, these brushes, at least the ones with the brown handle, are more on the cheapest side, because for some of them, few bristles are sticking out or they lose some bristle, but definitely they are not children's quality. Those are quite terrible, even for children, that sometimes are included in this kind of project. For a paint by number project that you usually work with acrylic paint, like in this case, you don't need expensive brushes, but it's nice to have a decent quality brush to work with. And these overall are nice quality. The tips are well pointed and they did their job very well. For me, 10 brushes were too many for this project, and I ended up using like 5 of them. Although in my opinion, you would only need 3 brushes, a small, a medium and a large size, and you are good to go. But the full set is a nice selection if you don't have many brushes to begin with that will last you for a while and that you can use for other paintings. Then I received extra tools that I didn't use, but the white small objects are wall hooks, or alternatively, you can use the frame hooks with screws that are also included that I used and screwed on the canvas to hang the painting on the wall. I also received a scratch painting that it looks like a print, but it's one of those paintings where you have to scratch the surface to reveal the colors underneath. The tool I'm using here is not included in the box, but I kept it from these kind of paintings that I used to do when I was a kid, and I love them. And the last but not least, the 24 color pots with a paint pot stand to place the colors. Actually, there are 26 pots for this painting because they packed 2 extra color for one of the background color, the purple, that really came in handy because as far as the quality of this paint goes, I would say they are quite good and the consistency was enjoyable to work with, but most of these colors aren't very covering and are more transparent. Well, light colors like yellow and pink are more transparent to begin with, so I was expecting them to not cover the numbers on the canvas on the first application with only one layer. So I ended up covering many of these numbers 2 times because I personally like to have a thick coverage when it comes to acrylic paint and paint by numbers paintings, so the numbers aren't too see-through. This is a personal preference, but the extra pot of the purple color for the background came in handy because I used 2 of 3 pots to get that nice thick coverage I wanted. And overall, the amount of paint provided was more than enough to cover everything, even 2 times. I didn't run out of any color, and actually I have a lot of paint left from each color, and I had enough to paint the edges of the canvas as well. This would be my biggest concern for this kind of project, that you don't get enough paint, especially if you don't own any other type of paint, and this is everything you have. But this wasn't the case at all. You get plenty of paint even if you apply it thickly. And the last thing I wanted to show you, you can turn the box into an easel to use for painting more comfortably, if you'd like. Which I love the creative way of using everything you get, so even the box as I use. And on the box you can find tips and instruction how to get started. You just need a cup or jar of water and a towel to clean your brushes, but this kit contains everything you need to get started painting. So yeah, let's move to the painting process, and while you see me painting, I will share with you my experience, my painting process, some tips and paint techniques for completing a paint by number painting, and talk more about craft ease as well. First of all, I wanted to tell you a bit more about craft ease and my experience with paint by number. There are several companies that make paint by numbers product. The ones I bought when I was a kid were from Ravensburger, not sure how to pronounce it, which is a famous German brand for children's toys and still is the main brand for kid toys in my local department stores in Switzerland. In fact, I went to my local stores and I checked if perhaps paint by numbers products were still on the shelves, but sadly they removed them, and it's really a shame because these projects are creative outlet for kids to be introduced to painting in a very fun and easy way. They can also be a means where family can spend a bonding time together and paint together. These memories and experience can affect kids positively, and these experience and memories will be part of their growth. It was for me at least. So it's a shame that they removed it from my local stores. There are still board games and puzzles and such, which I loved doing puzzles as well when I was a kid, so I'm glad they didn't remove them. There are still traditional games out there, and it's important that they still exist for kids to enjoy and discover their passions and unleash their creativity that aren't just electronic games, that can be educational as well, but is missing the physical and social interaction side of things. So I hope you get what I mean, that they are not the same thing. And even more, paint by numbers paintings are suitable to anyone. You don't have to be good to enjoy painting. You don't need specific skills to complete a paint by number painting. So it's very suitable for beginner painters of any age. And for me, there is something oddly satisfying to cover designated areas with paint, and it's a very exciting and rewarding feeling seeing your painting slowly come to life, especially when it's complete. And I just love the concept of following numbers where everything is laid out, so you don't have to think about anything. And having the colors ready to go, it's a lot simpler where you can resume painting at any time. And this can be a really amazing way to relax and take a moment for yourself. Painting can be therapeutic and has many health benefits, as it allows the mind to focus on the image at hand. It relieves stress in the mind, and it's a great way to disconnect from the world, from our busy life, and reconnect with ourselves. And I truly believe in so. For me, painting has always been a relaxing time and a distraction from my daily life. And paint by numbers projects are a great means to relieve the pressure that I put on myself. Especially now that making art is my job, I feel the pressure to make good art. So sometimes it's nice to just paint without worrying about what I'm creating. And the thing I really like about craft is that resonates with me is that they promote independent artists and collaborate with them by remunerating them for their hard work and inspiring art. So with every purchase from their exclusive series, you support the artist who created the original piece. If you have ever looked into paint by numbers from different brands, sometimes you don't know the artist name behind the original art piece, and it would be nice to know. Or you will see that many brands use the same images because they don't have royalties. So I love that Craft is focused on supporting independent artists, and their mission to offer a therapeutic experience in painting in a fun way with their products, and their aim for anybody to distract themselves from the stress they deal during the day, it resonates with my own beliefs as well. So I'm very grateful for this collaboration and also the opportunity that my platform gives me, meaning you as my audience for watching my videos, to bring and convey an important message to help people. So you see, I was very excited to make this video. And this exotic bouquet painting turned out so beautiful. The credits goes to Marla Jill for creating this lovely piece. If you are wondering, it took me about 7 hours to complete it, and I painted it some hours a day, so I completed it in about 4 days. But someone else might be faster or slower than me. And time here doesn't really matter. The purpose of this kind of project is to take it easy. Take your time to finish the painting because there is no rush to finish it quickly. And there are several approaches you can start your paint by number project. There is no wrong or right way, but I wanted to share some tips for completing a paint by number project more efficiently and creatively as well. You can paint one area at a time and switch the colors each time, or you can use one color at a time or start painting the colors that takes up the larger surfaces. Or there are even more approaches. I personally prefer using a color at a time and cover all the areas of that number, so I don't have to clean my brush that often. The paint dries pretty fast on the canvas, so you don't have to worry about dirtying your canvas. with paint when working on different areas at the same time. But don't forget to close well the lid of the colors pot when not in use, so the paint inside won't dry. And if you miss to cover a number along the way, that's no problem at all. You can always paint it later on. My recommendation though is to start with light colors, as darker color cover light colors, so it will be more tricky to cover dark colors with light colors. But not impossible, because being acrylic paint, the paint can be layered several times and it doesn't reactivate it with water once dry. So this means it allows you to cover your mistakes if you need. Also, in the case you would like to cover an area a second time if it's not opaque enough like I did, you just have to wait for the first layer to dry before applying a new coat of paint. While painting, I kept my brush a bit damp to spread the paint more evenly and more easily. It's a useful tip that you can use as well, but this paint felt fluid enough to spread it easily, so for me, it wasn't always necessary to work with a damp brush. And being acrylic paint, you can decide to lay down your color evenly or leave it more thick with visible strokes of paint on the canvas. And with acrylic paint, I personally like it to be more thick, which gives a more artistic look to the painting. In fact, you are free to use some painting techniques while painting, like for example, blending more colors together, fading, adding details, and more, to add your own twist and artistic flair to make it unique and outstanding. It is suggested to paint within the designated area with the right number. It is the main purpose of paint by number paintings after all, but you don't really have to be super precise, and this doesn't have to block you from painting the piece more spontaneously and improvise if you'd like, especially if you are already more familiar with painting. But even if you are a beginner to painting, this can be a great way to unleash your creativity and add your own personal touch to it. Like for example, for some colors, I changed them a little and I mixed few colors together to create new colors, because for this painting specifically, for me there were few colors too similar among each other, and I wanted them to be a bit different and have more color contrast and color variation on the painting. This required me a plate to mix colors, but it's optional because you can mix the colors directly on canvas, which I thought about it too late, but it's to show that you can add your own twist and change things up a little bit. Some of the techniques I used, in some areas I blended more colors together to give a more smooth look, but not everywhere, because I liked it to be more loose. That is different from my usual art style, but I like this kind of style as well. And I mostly added my personal touch toward the end, once the painting was finished. You can do it along the way, which I also did, but for me this way I had a better vision where I could add my personal touch. And if I had a very enjoyable and relaxing time while painting this piece, toward the end I also felt really excited and creative, which when I was a kid, I don't think I allowed myself to improvise like I did here, but probably because the thought of doing it just didn't cross my mind. But the message is that you don't have to just follow the numbers. You can change things up if you like doing it. I believe the main purpose of paint by number project is to be comfortable when painting without feeling any pressure. It can also empower people to be more confident and to build up our painting skills. So if you feel brave to change things up, go for it. But if you don't have the confidence yet, it's totally okay to just follow the numbers. Nobody is going to judge the approach you take. And don't forget that completing the painting is already a great achievement, which you can feel very proud, and it will be a very rewarding feeling. And you will have an amazing painting that you painted with your hand to hang in your house. So yeah, I think that's everything. I want to thank Craft Ease for this collaboration and for sending me this kit. and let me know if you would be interested on watching more of these videos about Paint by Numbers, because I love painting these kind of projects and it would be a pleasure for me to make more videos about it. Have you ever painted with Paint by Numbers like me when I was younger? If so, let me know in the comment section below. If you would be interested in buying your Paint by Number kit from Craft Ease and support the artist of the purchased artwork, you will find a promo code to use to get 20% off with your order. And I will leave all the details and the links in the description of this video. So yeah, that's everything. Thank you so much for watching and for your support. I really hope you enjoyed watching this video, and I will see you in the next video. Bye!